Dream League. Tonight is the last night of league play, and that means it is serious business here at the DreamHack Monster Energy Studios. Here for the final night is Gods, David Parker.
Good evening, Shiva.
Good evening.
Glad to see we've stepped things up here at the Aces RG Dream League. Made things more professional. It's just going to be a much clean... Mr. Owen Davies, the other one, please. We've cleaned things up here and looking to do a much more tight, polished show tonight.
Mr. Owen Odipixel Davies?
Absolutely looking forward to a very serious show. Normally, I go with the funny jokes and the memes to appeal to the idiot children in Twitch chat, but today we are looking to the broader audience and reading the Reddit comments of professionalism and how we can improve esports and make sure that one day we'll be on the proper TV so proper people can enjoy this proper sport.
And of course, Yannis Fogged Lucas.
Thank you, Shiver. You know, I tend to be the more serious one overall, but it's glad to see my companions actually pick it up a notch, and we'll see how it goes from here.
Let's get the show started. Welcome to the Aces ROG Dream League. We are here for four games of Dota 2 tonight. We are going to see Imperial play two series of Dota. And their first series will be going up against Escape Gaming. Their second series against Vega Squadron. And all these series mean a lot for both Imperial and Vega Squadron, but not for Escape, as Escape is already through. And of course, here with me to guide you through all the action tonight, my team, it is Gods, Odipixel, and Fogged. Gods, how are you feeling this evening?
Feeling absolutely fantastic. I'm glad we've got Imperial playing. They're a very proper-sounding team, you know. Mm-hmm. This is the kind of team we want representing the Aces RG Dream League.
For sure. What do you reckon about tonight, Odipixel?
Absolutely. We've got some tip-top teams, teams that don't mess around. We're not going to see any kind of silly behavior, all very serious stuff. People picking in the meta picks, no kind of off-the-wall drafting, which I hate to see. It's a disgrace, really. It makes this look like some sort of game, which it isn't. This is a serious sport, and we're going to have some serious action here today.
What have you thought about the season so far, Fogged?
It's been quite good, honestly. I mean, this is a very deciding day, like we were mentioning. This is the deciding series for both of these teams. Imperial needs to get at least, what, one win, I believe it is, while Vega needs to get several wins. So this is going to be a very, very deciding game, very deciding day, and it's going to be difficult for both squads.
Yeah, any team that has surprised you over the course of 5 weeks, Scott?
As far as the whole list of teams going, there's been a few teams that have been bit disappointing. If you look at like towards NP and stuff, obviously even before they pulled out, they didn't play well. Mm-hmm. VP delivered on expectation. I think the surprise is perhaps the team we're going to see today, Imperial. They've managed to maintain this fantastic, consistent level of play. We saw them before Aces RG Dream League. We hyped them up because they did so well at the WESG LAN, and they've maintained that kind of level of play and brought it here, and looking to finish that in the top four.
Do you share God's enthusiasm, Odipixel?
Absolutely. I'm looking forward to seeing Imperial. I'm looking forward to seeing Escape Gaming. You know, after they lost one of their players in a $5 million deal to Team Secret. With Kezu gone, who are we going to see? What are we going to see them perform? How are we going to see them perform? Is it still going to be Sindarin doing Sindarin things? Are they going to go a little bit more fanatic? We saw them play with Trixie the other day. Maybe they're going to bring Trixie in again. I'm looking forward to that. I'm also looking forward to see if indeed Imperial can secure their place. I believe there's very strict restrictions on how many games they need to win now at this point to get themselves a place. Otherwise, the place will be going to Vega Squadron, I believe.
Yeah, and it is confirmed that Escape will play with Trixie. What do you think about that, Fogged?
I think it's pretty interesting. Trixie actually hasn't played, on a big professional team in quite a while. He's been just kind of standing in for some teams here and there. And I think he was playing for... Who was it, the last one? I'm kind of drawing a blank who the last team he played for was, but I know it was Fnatic was the big one. But he plays for
Four Anchors.
Four Anchors, that's right.
Four Anchors. And a sea captain.
It has been a while for him, but the nice little thing that they do have is, you know, Era and Trixie were quite close friends in the past, you know, team friendship, Fnatic. So that'll be pretty cool to see how the synergy between them two, you know, kind of shines in this new roster that we're seeing.
Now, of course, for us, it is a very serious time as this is the last day of league play for the Aces RG Dream League. But there is another competition going on, or will start very shortly, in a country across an ocean that is also very serious. It is Hillary versus Trump. Now, you guys at home can be a part of this competition, or our very own version of it anyway. ! Hillary or ! Trump to show your support. And below we will show right there the results of our esteemed voters. What do you think, gods? Would you vote for Trump or Hillary?
You know, I looked at this like, who would win in a Dota match between the
in
two?
In a Dota match, yeah.
Yeah, so first I thought, with a captain team. Now I'm like, no. We're looking at 1v1 middle lane, like Hillary versus Trump. Like, I think it's kind of hero dependent. I don't know what you guys think here. What kind of theorycrafting heroes you'd like to see?
Heroes I'd associate. I believe, for me personally, I think Hillary would be absolutely fantastic on any kind of high nuke burst damage hero because she's great at deleting things. Mm-hmm. And then you look towards Trump, I think his hero could be Slark because you can win games even if you're a fucking moron.
Yes, this is actually, that's very good analysis. I think other heroes, probably for Trump, you were kind of bantering about it before, is, you know, the Darkseer, of course, and the Earthshaker, I would say, as well, because, you know, very easily just build that wall, not have to worry about anybody crossing through it.
So. Earthshaker, very good. He's very orange in color as well.
Yes.
Definitely plays to Trump's strengths. Yeah.
Kind of like me.
Hillary, I think you can also consider the Alchemist. I mean, a lot of money rolling in. It's definitely great hero for the economy, so good stuff.
Yeah,
and other heroes for Hillary, you mentioned burst damage heroes because she's great at the leading stuff. What other heroes? I mean, Lina comes to mind for that one. Which other heroes could Hillary be very well versed at?
Well, I mean, all the burst ones, like right, Lion especially too. Mm-hmm. You know, you just bam, get rid of something.
Would she only play female heroes?
I don't know about that.
It's hard to tell. I mean, female heroes might remind her of other females in the past that have had altercations with her husband, so maybe not for that situation. Yes. Yeah.
Indeed.
And Lion, I would say, but
I think Trump would definitely play with the female heroes, though.
He'd play with all the female heroes. Yep. He would know how to grab them, how to control them, and use them absolutely perfectly, just as female heroes should be used. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's very good analysis.
Very good analysis. I'm curious to see what our Twitch viewers thought about that analysis.
Oh, look at that.
Most of them are voting for Trump, and as you can see, Hillary is very sad.
There's a lot of slark pickers in Twitch chat.
Yeah.
Probably a lot of Redditors as well. You know, these people who are always right and Trump being right. It's you know, it goes as with the people in chat.
They speak. Mm-hmm. He speaks his mind. They
Absolutely.
Speak their mind.
Yes. I mean, the question is, what Twitch emote would Trump and Hillary be?
Ooh, that's a very good question.
That's a very good question.
I think Hillary would be OS Frog, right?
Or
she just like
Hot Pocket.
Swindles it in a way.
Hot Pocket
as well.
Yes.
I mean, she may feel that she's being internally oppressed, so Hot Pocket could be very relevant against Trump. Yes.
As for Trump?
Probably debated.
Debated.
Yeah.
I would say debated.
How it makes most people feel.
Yes.
Yeah.
I would definitely agree with that.
Maybe a slight Kappa?
Yeah, maybe.
A slight cap.
Pretty big one today.
Slight, a pretty
slight,
big
slight
one.
Cap and foreheads for sure.
Yeah. Yes, a few foreheads, maybe a few lulls in there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And maybe a few fish mollies as well. You don't use better Twitch TV.
Fish molly.
Do you not use better
you
Twitch
don't
TV?
Use better
no, I do,
Twitch.
But this one.
Blasphemy.
I'll just agree.
Honestly, I can't believe they let you on a panel.
Sorry.
So, other things you can vote for today, as the vote for Hillary and Trump will remain open for a little while longer, we have another vote that, well, that you guys might find interesting, because tonight it is your turn to decide what the red button will be. Is it exclamation mark jokes for awkward jokes, exclamation mark story for story time, exclamation mark Jenga for playing Jenga, exclamation mark animal for having an animal in the studio or any other animal related activities, or exclamation mark faces for a split face between who remains to be seen. But it is your choice, so vote carefully.
It's a fantastic picture of you, Shiva.
Yes.
Thank you.
Mm. I like it.
It resembles me very well.
Mm.
Yes, I'm very proud of that picture. I consider myself very photogenic. Thank you. So, on with it then. Dota 2 is on the agenda.
Yes, thank God.
Thank God. We had some Dota 2 yesterday as well, and we can take a look at what happened in that one series that we had yesterday evening.
Chopper sent you, but VP's still got that high ground board, so the hook potential's there. They catch out Skylar, bring him in. The rock will be dropped, though. Vacuum coming through, and they manage to take down Lil in return. Solo falling low. He'll demonic purge, though, but still the chaotic offering golem chases him down, takes a second. Pasha coming back into the fight, still eyeing them for the high ground.
Oh, nice.
Oh, it will take down the golem, yeah. Indeed, and Pasha comes in with a three-man crush. The four-man Starstorm, no one jumps forward. They take one, they take two. Doug, he's in trouble as well as Ramsey's focusing with the open wounds. Doug trying to turn, but he's out. They've lost another. There'll be buybacks coming out on two.
Five bottom, though. There's no Legion here.
They'll go in. We'll grab the axe. Immediate disruption. Thug turning up, looking to find this fight for Abfin, and Madara coming into the front of it. But he's going to be jeweled, and in fact, nearly taken down. Yay. The dog comes too early, though, so he lives through it. It's a one for one, two supports dropping. Madara still alive, finally falls, though. But they've got the cold snap. Have they got the damage? That's the question. Over the EMP and the cold snap just holding in place, he's got to kill himself. Thug knocks himself out, but they've lost three. The tornado from no one, catching out Skylark. They chase in, get the call with the axe. And again, VP taking these fights absolutely beautifully.
An unusual occurrence, a 2-0 in the Aces Argy Dream League. That is not something that we were expecting here at the panel, were we, gods?
No, normally teams are more gentlemanly. They just give one game each, you know. The way they started Dream League worked, it's all rigged. We just give everyone draws and everyone walks away happy.
Everyone gets $1,000 per series.
But VP were not on that page yesterday.
They broke
disappointing
the rules.
Stuff.
Disappointing stuff for Adfinim.
Yeah.
Yes.
VP just kind of slaughtered them a bit. Rough to watch.
Yeah. What did you think about yesterday's series, Odie Pixel?
Yes, it was entertaining. I did love the first game where VP picked four very proper heroes that are absolutely disgusting, very strong at the moment, and then they picked Pudge, which at the time I was a little bit like, oh, excuse me, this is a little bit edgy. I don't know if I can quite deal with this sort of hero in my games. But it won the game, and it kind of won me over as well.
Yeah.
As someone before who was a little bit more kind of averse to the larger-sized heroes in the game, like Pudge, now I'm very much more for people picking Pudge and playing it in my pub games as well.
Hmm.
Let's take a look at what yesterday's games did to the standings in our league play games, as for Virtus Pro, yesterday's games already didn't mean much. They made it to the top. 10-4, 14 games played, they're done.
VP yesterday also, they did, because they won their games, they secured Liquid's position, I want to say.
Yes.
So I Liquid is also going to be playing at the ASUS ROG Dream League finals.
Escape Gaming will join them as well, and then the fourth position is still to be decided. It could be Imperial, it could also be still Vega Squadron.
Yes.
There's a lot of options still left open, and
two options really.
Two options. There's two options still open. Sorry there. It's going to be either Imperial or Vega, and we have four Imperial games today, so they have a lot of opportunities to make it through tonight. Now, gentlemen, you are going to commentate these matches. I want to hear from you if you think that again there will be 1-1 games after what we saw yesterday. That teams can go 2-0. Are we going to see something like that again?
You know, Escape's always... They've never been really true to the Dream League spirit. That's why they're at the top. They often take some wins themselves, but playing with a stand-in will definitely, I think, hinder them a little bit against what's looking like a very strong Imperial team. The way Imperial like to draft and play is definitely a bit unconventional, and that's something which will throw teams off, and I think Escape will have trouble dealing with. I think Imperial will take at least one of the two games... Quite likely both.
What do you think, Cody Pixel?
Oh, I think Imperial are likely to take every game today. I mean, they're playing against what, Sin's team first. As you said, they've got a new player joining. It's going to be a little bit of a mess, to be fair. And then the second series, I can't even remember who they're playing. Who are they playing?
Vega Squadron.
Exactly. I don't know them. You don't know them. They're probably going to lose as well. So Imperial to take four games today, in my opinion.
I'm gonna have to disagree. Okay. I'm going to have to say that Imperial is going to win the first two versus Escape, but however, I think Vega is going to bring it back. I was chatting with FN a bit. He seemed very confident coming into these games. So,
what words did he use? He's normally fairly controversial.
He's fairly controversial. His words were more like, don't ask me why I sold my Basher. And then it was just, we are going to win. He's a man of very little words.
Wow. We are going to win, guys.
Two
win. Yes. I just won. And it seems that as a result of you guys' votes, we are going to have a new president on our hand. The vote will still remain open, though, for if you want to have a say in who will win the vote. Hillary versus Trump, ! Hillary or ! Trump. That vote will pop up multiple times throughout the evening, I would imagine. Also, don't forget to vote for our red button. And I'm sure you can find the commands for that in the chat. And if you want to vote more, if you want to put in more commands in the chat, which I can imagine you want to do because you want to have that kind of power to make messages appear in chat, you can put ! Full voltage. And then you get information about that beautiful laptop that you see over there. That is an ROG Strix. It has a i7, full voltage i7, yes, that's right, in there, as well as a GTX 1060 graphics card. It is a GL702VM ROG Strix, so make sure to check that one out, as it is a beast of a compact gaming PC. Now, gentlemen, it is time for you to take your seats at the casting desk and for us to make space also to welcome in our guest of the week.
Yes, sir.
Welcome, PyCat.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
How are you doing this evening?
It's a pleasure to be here. I'm looking forward to today's games.
Yes. Who are you expecting to come out victorious in this, you know, four game series?
Well, as a Swede, I would have to go with the Danes, our fellow brothermen.
Okay.
I believe they will go 4-0 today. I have faith in Bobby Knight.
You have faith in Bobby Knight.
Yes, and I think that they will do well.
Wow. Anything specific you're looking forward to in their games, or just some straightforward Imperial stuff?
Yeah, some pretty straightforward. I believe they're going to pick OD. Yes. And he's going to win his lane, maybe a centaur in there.
Yeah.
And it's going to be a pretty easy walk in the park.
Okay, we can take a look at Imperial's preferred picks and the heroes that are most banned against them. As we have that, of course, on stats right here, provided by datdota.com. Preferred picks by Imperial: the Ogre Magi, the Batrider, the Rubik, the Centaur, and the Oracle. And most banned against them is Mirana, Kunkka, Slark, Sand King, and Juggernaut. Is one of those heroes standing out particularly to you, Fogged?
The big one to me, at least from the performance that they had versus Liquid the other day, is definitely the Batrider. That's Hester Joe's Batrider. Even Jacob Milk was very much so adhering to how expert level this guy plays the Batrider, and he delivered over and over with that. You know, even I mean, Milk even called it. He's like, this guy's gonna get an Aghanim Scepter, and he's gonna own. And it happened. The Aghanims didn't get many multiple lassos, but still, it had its effect, and he had. He dragged a Shadow Fiend with two rapiers and killed him. I mean, what more could you ask for?
That is about all you can ask for.
Not a lot more
at all. We have also got a team plate of Escape Gaming and see what their most preferred picks and most banned against them heroes are. And preferred picks are Dazzle, Invoker, Mirana, Slardar, and Beastmaster. Mm. While most banned against Escape Gaming is Io, Drow Ranger, Darkseer, Shadow Demon, and the Batrider, again, making an appearance there. What stands out most for you there, Pycat?
I think the Beastmaster is and the Invoker are two heroes that we see Escape frequently play. Mm-hmm. Now, however, without Kezu, it's going to be interesting to see whether they're still going to pick up that Beastmaster.
Yeah.
The Invoker is a hero that they tend to like a lot, and as far as I know, that Imperial do not pick that hero very much. So perhaps Invoker versus OD matchup, something we could see, unless teams decide to ban those two heroes out for the other one.
Did you know that this is one of the, I think, I want to say it is the first Aces RG Dream League where there has not been a patch, a big patch, happening in the middle of our league play season.
Wow.
Kind of surprising, of course, as we are still sticking with the same patch for, I believe, the Boston Major as well, from all signs that are there. Now, if you would change something, are there some heroes that you think would warrant a nerf or change in some way?
I believe just maybe some small changes, nothing like over the top, but I think we could all agree that OD might be a little bit too strong, just like some cooldown changes on the Astral specifically in the laning phase and just later on stages. And also, I guess maybe just from the win rate, especially at the Aces ROG Dream League, is the Lifestealer that I've been seeing especially. Mm-hmm. So maybe some small tweaks, but nothing too excessive.
What about you, Pycat?
Well, as Fog mentioned, I think that perhaps the damage nerf to OD was not the nerf that we were looking for, but rather something to the Astral imprisonment.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
As it seems to be a bit too strong.
Quite
strong. Times. Other than that...
Would you not like to see a change for... obviously,
I think
Bat
that
Rider
perhaps
Drow
Ranger, the hero should be tweaked a little bit. The alternative is that you buff some of the other heroes, which Iceberg has done in the past.
Yes.
And you could buff other heroes that are good, potentially, against the Drow Ranger. Maybe we would see Lycan come back into play, then we would see Drow be played less.
How about not?
And other heroes a little bit. The aura makes it so that Drow Ranger is very, very strong in combination with any range heroes, and the pushing power is sometimes overwhelming.
Hmm. How about not hero specific? How do you feel about this is something I was actually thinking, is the item Hurricane Pike in general.
Yes, Hurricane Pike.
Seems it's very strong, obviously, like indeed, on these and ranged heroes, like Drow Ranger, OD, these are the ones like we just mentioned, and they massively benefit from it, so maybe we'll see that get some more slight tweaks as we have seen it in the past.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, maybe you can no longer Hurricane Pike out of Clockwork's Cox, but only four staff, so that the carries can no longer do it. Yeah. So
definitely
something to think about there.
Definitely
Iceman
passability, yes.
OS Frog, take notes. Also, just to remind you guys at home that tonight for us is a serious stream because it is serious business. This is the last night of the Aces RG Dream League league play. And we have Imperial playing for their tournament lives, as it were, as well as Vega Squadron later tonight. Both teams still having a chance to make it to the top four and appear at DreamHack Winter in the LAN finals for $175,000. So
big money.
Big money. Serious business, yes. Serious stream. That is how we roll, and that is what the teams deserve as well. And that is also what we have taken from you guys' feedback over the last few weeks. This is what you were asking for, so we hereby deliver it to you as well.
All we're trying to do here is trying to make Dota great again.
Yes. This is indeed the case. And speaking of that, let's see if we are making the world a better place. Let's see the results so far for hashtag Hillary, not hashtag, exclamation mark Hillary or exclamation mark Trump. If you guys want to vote in the chat, the vote is still open. And it seems that Trump is still winning and Hillary is still looking quite sad there on the left side.
Yeah, when the chat unites, they are stronger together.
Yes.
Wouldn't you say so?
Yes.
That is definitely true.
It's a scary thing, the mob mentality.
It is. It truly is.
The power of a hive mind.
Yes.
It has been working out. Also, remember that you also have the chance to vote for our red button tonight. And those commands you can find somewhere in the chat. But there is another vote that will open up right now. That's right. More votes, of course, tonight for our first series, Imperial versus Escape Gaming. We have selected, this is the red button vote first. And so far, it looks like the story time. Red button is winning, while...
Animal is winning.
I am blind. I am my deepest apologies for misreading the results. Exclamation mark joke. Jokes, exclamation mark, story, exclamation mark,
Jenga, I just want to clarify that we at Dream League here do not condone Shiver's mistakes.
Yes. Don't worry. I will have to, I probably won't get paid today either.
She'll be docked one day of pay for sure. Yes.
Yeah. Unfortunately, that is the way of the world. Now for our third voting possibility for you guys. Let's take a look at which five players you can vote for. For the MVP of the first series of the night, MVP 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 are Yapzor, Ryze, Hester Joe Rotten, Koikfa, and Era that you can vote for. And of course, the voting will only start once the game has actually kicked off after the draft. And it will run for the entire two-game series. So you have a lot of chances to vote and also to evaluate the players and actually vote proper rather than making it a vote based on the player you like most.
So, Paikai, what hero do you think is going to be the most contested between these two teams? Just to pick your brain a bit.
Well, we saw both of the teams seem to be favoring Batrider.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So I'm looking to see if it might be the case that both of those teams might want to get the Batrider.
Mm-hmm.
Sand King is another hero that I know that at least Escape have picked a bit. But I'm not so sure if
Hester Joe has
Imperial.
Usually, when the Batrider is gone,
Rubik is another hero that both teams seem to like quite a bit. We've seen both Ryze and Yapzor get their hands on that hero, and so those are some of the heroes that I think we might see.
Last time we talked about Imperial, it seemed that we came to the conclusion that Imperial does well when they can throw their opponents off guard, when they do something that their opponents are not expecting, aka not picking standard meta picks, something that our commentators are quite fearful of, actually.
Yeah, it's quite appalling, I think, as a viewer of Dota 2. We like seeing the same heroes.
Yeah. Makes it a more stable.
So that we understand what is going on.
Yes, because once you pick new heroes, it throws off everything. You have to explain absolutely everything that's going on because nobody knows. Nobody knows what these other heroes do. Yeah. It
ruins the viewer's experience.
I think so.
Yes.
So are we expecting any odd heroes here for Imperial? Or are we gonna see them do the same comfortable things that we have seen them do last week?
I think like you kind of mentioned, is like the OD. That's like the big one, at least in mine, and then the Batrider. I think that they're going to stick with what they kind of played versus Liquid because they had such a great showing versus them. So yes. I think that's hopefully what we'll see them do, just because these games are incredibly important for them
they
to make
are,
it.
They really are.
So
that cannot be stressed enough. Imperial needs at least one win if they want to make it through to league play. But preferably for them, they'll get 2 out of 4 tonight. Yeah. Yes, and I believe we are soon loading into the draft as well, so that we can see what the teams have in store for each other. And we already expect Batriders, Rubix. Are there any heroes that we're going to see banned out every single time?
Probably the...
Shadow Demon?
Shadow Demon.
Comes to mind.
I think Escape has been having some rough times with Luna in general for themselves, while Imperial does like to play the Luna a lot. So maybe we'll see that one just get banned out just because they don't, you know, Escape kind of struggles on it.
Yeah.
I'm kind of curious about how you feel about like this whole Trixie being brought in, just because we kind of mentioned it a bit before you got brought in. How do you feel he's going to fare up with Escape and, you know, just in this lineup, since it's been a while for him?
Yeah, well, I think, as you previously mentioned, he used to play with Era back in the days, so there might still be some synergy. They might know how to play with one another and kind of know how one another thinks.